Hey, what's going on? It's David Avellan. I'm here with my friend Kit Dale. And, you know, having worked with Kit for maybe like the past week or so, I've learned quite a few things from him, and just he's brought to my conscious awareness some concepts that make guard passing a lot more effective. And I want to use that to go over one of my favorite passes, which is the knee cut pass. And again, my brother and I have used this all over in Grappler's Quest, Naga, ADCC, and it's probably like one of the best passes that I have in my game. But even so, there was things that I was doing subconsciously without realizing the importance of certain aspects. So I'm gonna go ahead and demonstrate first and then break it down. So let's go ahead and break it down. So when I'm in this guard, first of all, if you're dealing with a closed guard, you gotta open it, all right? My favorite way of opening it is just a basic knee wedge. Well, come here, break. Okay, now the main thing with a knee wedge for me is to have an explosive pop, okay? Meaning that I see a lot of people that come here, they put a knee in the middle, they slowly come back, and then they're doing this little Charlie horse bruise to try to grind the guy open. And with any grip, I want to use explosive force. And this guard is probably one of the stronger grips that you'll face. So when I get my knee here, I'm going to explode my hips way out. Because remember, what your hips are doing, in essence, are stretching his guard so that at a certain point, his legs will pop. And right now, we're going in a straight line. But when my hips are there, okay, his legs can only stay closed for a certain distance. Okay, so when I'm here, whoop, pop, boom, okay? So that's my legs and hips. My hands, I'm trying to use like the hooks of my thumbs to dig in the lower rib cage. And I'm also pushing out and creating a strong posture here, boom, trying to break, all right? Now, if he is holding very strong and I don't break the guard and I just get out here, then I'll use my hands or my elbows. But I'm not going like in the middle of the thigh here. I want to get all the way towards the knee. If you think of using a door, pretend this is the hinge, this is the handle. If you ever try to open a door by pushing the hinge, it's very difficult, right? Because you don't have a lot of torque. I'm going to try to climb all the way up to the handle. Okay, so me doing this versus me doing this is a lot more effective, okay? Especially if I pop it. If I come here, ah, boom, I can break. Much so, even with one hand, I can just push out, break that guard, okay? Once the guard's broken, then I'm gonna get into my combat base, boom, right here. I put one knee in the center, hands are still controlling the hips. I wanna bring my posture a little high here. Now, this is where I'm gonna get into a little bit what Kit had shown me and brought to awareness, which is controlling the upper body, right? And pretty much, Kit, you could probably, I'll have you explain it, you could probably do a better job than me.
So one of the problems people have mostly when they pass the guard is that they don't control the upper body. They don't attach themselves to the upper body. So what'll happen is they'll pass, but then get pushed off and they'll lose the pass. So what I stress on is not rushing the pass too quickly, but really setting up some kind of finishing grips on the upper body, so by the time you do pass, it's too late for me to push them off.
Correct. So like for me here, that would be this underhook, right? Because as you were saying, if I just focus on passing his legs, because right now, if you see the leg, I pass his foot. So now I'm dealing with like his hips, a little bit of his thigh, and his hands. And if I ignore the hands and just get excited that I'm so close to getting by his legs here, boom, he's gone. I know personally this happened to me plenty of times, just trying to rush a pass and then we're in a scramble, all right? So instead here, looking to get that far underhook, and then this hand also, whenever possible, control something here, whether I'm grabbing the wrist, tricep, even the elbow, anything is better than nothing there. Excuse me. So now from here, oh, hips come out, all right? When I'm doing like a baseball slide, I've seen people do different variations. Some people try try to go up this way. I've seen people slide out that way. Okay, either way, for me, it's fine. The only thing, I don't like sliding too much out to the side here, because now his leg has more control to come in. Okay, so I like to come up here. But just realize, the tighter you are to him, the harder it is for your leg to escape, usually because your foot, or sometimes your knee, is gonna get caught up on his body and get dragged. Like if I go right through the groin here, I'm gonna get caught on his undercarriage, right? And not be able to pass through. So I want a slight angle, all the way down. Now this is the second point where a lot of people get excited. They passed, but this is like a low side control. If Kit just pops his hips right now, space is made, he's getting out. And if I try to stay there too long, I even give him a omoplata, and then or an arm bar, if he throws a leg over. Okay, so from the beginning here, boom, break, base, secure that top control, boom. Once I pass here, I'm not done. I advance as high as I can. All right, so if we circle a little bit this way. A side control that's low in the hips is weak, all right, because I'm sitting over his power. So using my underhook and the wrist control, the shoulder control, tricep, I walk my way up here, where now the side of my body is resting over the shoulder line. So if he pops up now, nothing happens. The other thing here, since I'm higher up, his arms are much harder, he's gonna have a much harder time getting a good frame. When I'm down here, even though I control them, he can reestablish his frame and block me from advancing. When I get up this high, right here now, everything's stuffed, okay? And the other thing there, head down, right? Because even though I do this and I'm looking up at the crowd, you know, he could easily get a frame on that jawline and it's gonna ruin your day. So really tuck in, boom, get tight there so you block the hands entirely from doing anything. Now, some other extra details here for the knee cut. One, if I bring this leg up, I can drive off of it to get some more pop. Like if I'm just by myself here, you know, rather than just doing this, like a heel to a knee and coming down, I could propel myself right here. All right, so you can jump much further through. So we come again. If I'm here, I got this control. Boom. And that's already pushing me almost to high side control. Okay. The other thing, try not to focus so much on your knee hitting the mat, more so your hip coming over your knee. All right? Because what's really what I want is my hips to get over the top. Because if my knee is just here, you know, he's still fine. All right, and what that's gonna do, see how I bring my hip over? It's gonna allow the knee to slide further up. So if I'm here controlling, boom. And now I finish real high now. All right guys, so that is the knee cut, deconstructed step by step, all right? I wanna thank my buddy Cadell, having trained with him, you know, many of you might have seen him just on the internet being funny, but really, really knowledgeable guy with a very different approach. It's opened my eyes to a lot of things. So if you can, go check out our site, kiddaletraining.com. There'll be a link on the description below. Thank you, Kit.
Thank you, Mike. Awesome stuff.
Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please like and leave a comment below. Now, if you want to get more weekly videos right into your YouTube inbox, subscribe to my channel now. And for even more blog articles and videos, you can visit my website, which is davidavellan.com, and you can also learn more about my courses there.